Now, a couple of more tips for those who aren't too shallow. When you do with your tailplane, make sure you put that in. You pin that break it, it's really be bad news, so I'm told. I take out the outside pins of the elevator, leave the two inside pins in. Take those out, and all is well. A couple of things I've done. I've increased the fuel feed from the main tank to slipper tank to 12mm for a faster slipper tank fill. And you'll see I put a bypass in on the hand squadgy pump, which hopefully will prevent the squadgy pump let me down Monday. Very important piece of string. Over there. Under there, hold the canopy up. It's a very good idea to have the canopy up when you're refueling, because if you splash fuel on the glass, extra glass, it will damage it, so canopy.
Well, some of the bits and pieces I use. First of all, the chock. Secondly, the wingtip dolly. It's a standard wingtip dolly with casters and that light on it and a strap to hold the wing upright. The other one, swivelling one, is pretty similar. Just made so that it swivels. You can turn the wing horizontally or vertically, as you choose. And we have in my hangar wall slots for the tailplane. We have the elevator, and we have the hangar floor with yellow marks so that when I pull the airplane in, if I follow the yellow marks, I can't hit anything and damage anything. Well, the rest of the kit I use. This is what I hang the strap from. It's extension from the hanger box. I did used to use the eyelet below it, but then if you use the extension, then you can have the wing well outside of the hanger box, and there's less danger of damaging anything. The actual hanging strap, quite simple. It's a piece of plastic tube, plumbing tube with 45 degree ends. There's some insulation on it, an adjuster on that end so you can put it up or let it down. The tube helps the wing to sit level and you can move it about quite easily. The other things I use are a bit of a chock and a ramp, because the ground where I am is very uneven. So I use that to level things up. If you've got level ground, so much the better. The hanging strap you've seen, doesn't matter how long that is, as long as the aileron pushrod hangs clear, it's okay. And a sharpened up half-inch socket extension bar, I just ground it slightly so it fits into the pinholes of the wing quite easily and gives you a temporary hold while you're getting things to match. And of course, a little box to put all your nuts and bolts and bits and pieces in. I always put all my pins and things back in the aircraft and I'll take them out, because if you leave them in a box like that, then kick it over the long grass, it's quite tricky to find it all. And of course, plenty of rag and stuff to keep cleaning your hands as you're rigging. Well, that's it pretty much, so I hope you've enjoyed this little film and not got too bored with it.